I think it started on what I believed to be the worst day of my life. I was 53, and a reporter with the Denver Post learned that my father had come into my room at night when I was 5, and that it didn't stop until I was 18. I'd had a really brutal recovery. I had night terrors every night until I was 51. I had horrific flashbacks. I had a complete breakdown in my 40s. I was hospitalized 4 times. But people didn't know. People didn't know. As long as people don't know. And then you look at the Denver Post, and it's on the front page, and everybody knows. It's over. All the success I had worked for, it's over. Larry drew the shades, and we just sat there. And the phone rang, and a woman said, "You need to have a press conference." I said, "Never." She said, "They'll call your mother and your sisters." I said, "What time is the press conference?" The next day, it was on both papers' front page. The third day, both papers' front page. Larry, Jennifer, and I went out. We just had to get some air. And a woman stopped me, and she said, "We're so proud of what you're doing, Marilyn, but yesterday, on our most popular radio talk show, some people were calling in to say they didn't believe you." I was stunned. I looked at her and I said, "If people are not going to believe 53-year-old me, then who is going to believe a child?" That was life-changing for me. I went home, I called the newspapers, TV stations. I said, "Let's get to work." And the mail came in mail bags. People were knocking at my door. The Kemp Center called and said, "We cannot answer the hundreds of people who are calling." So I called my retired youth minister and I said, "Gird up your loins. We have to get to work." We saw up to 500 people a week for 3 years at no charge. And I began speaking. I've spoken in over 500 cities, and you do the newspaper interview first, educate, educate, educate. 1 in 4 girls, 1 in 6 boys will be violated before the age of 18. And the fundraiser to raise money for the Children's Center, and then speak. I always ask survivors to stand, but the one thing that I can do is to give hope. When someone emails me, they know I have been to the bottom of the well, and they know I came up. And what I can tell them is, you can do this. It's doable if, that's the word, if you're willing to do the work of healing. And they'll email back and say, "Well, I can't confront my father because," well, we need to do the work of healing. Sometimes you think you're gonna die and you do it anyway. The name of the book is Miss America by Day. And I'm glad I waited 11 years. I never really thought about writing a book. But the more I traveled and the more I listened and the more educating I knew I could do, it became extremely important to me. We don't know how to stop a man like my father, but we do know how to stem the tide of teenagers inappropriately touching younger or less powerful children, and we do it by talking to them. They have no idea they can be causing literally a lifetime of pain. And you know what's exciting? Parents go home and they talk to their kids. Someone asked me if I would choose what happened to me to be able to do what I'm doing today. It was way too hard. But this is the hand I was dealt, and it is an unbelievable privilege to be able to reach out, especially online, and just on a daily basis, just be able to give someone some hope for tomorrow. My life has been so richly blessed.